One alive, one strong.
Yeah, you still got a full cup over there. Full of tequila.
It's full of Mountain Dew.
Allegedly.
Hey.
Yes, sir.
I couldn't figure out what I was going to say there.
Yes, sir.
Anyway, let's move past that. I am yes, JR the Geek. This is Fat. Judah is in the back. Well, yes. Actually, he's on the side, but you know the rhyme. Well, this is Conversations with LFants. We are here. This is episode, I don't know. It doesn't matter. Don't ask me.
Don't ask.
You know what I mean? I'm sorry. I don't know.
Oh, that might be a new drop. This is episode, don't ask me. It doesn't matter.
We're here.
He's right. It doesn't matter. We're here. Yes, it's law of love. Glad to see you.
So what's going on, guys?
It's good to see y'all, man. The boys are back in town. It's good to see you guys, man.
I don't know if it's hot or cold outside.
That's it's a cold. Fact. Keeps, I can't deal with it being...
Thing Texas does.
You know? Yeah. Well, it was kind of chilly today.
About 20 in the morning, like 70 by like 2 o'clock is nuts.
At this point,
right now.
At this point, I can't be surprised anymore. This is how it is, bro. This has been like this since we were children.
But at the end of the day, that's pretty effing nuts. That it's...
Don't censor yourself.
I did censor myself. You got to.
How old are you? 14?
I was think I was like less censored at 14.
These probably, but you got the point.
Yes.
What? Oh, you got him.
I got an account. Damn, man.
You definitely have. Well, no, JR. It is JR's account.
You definitely got to edit that.
Y'all, how's your mental? How's everything going? How's your mental?
Oh, man.
That's a deep question. Yeah, don't even open that can of worms.
It's a thick question.
We're not here for that.
Yo, we're here for everything, man. It's good to see. I'm happy to see you.
We ain't got enough time for that.
We'll just say
good for what, times.
Stable, yeah.
For political purposes.
Yeah.
Mental is stable.
Stable's better, yeah.
For political gains.
Yeah, bro, how about you?
Pretty good, surprisingly, honestly. Been doing a lot better than what I've been doing lately. So it's pretty good. Been getting a lot of little blessings here and there to where you like, where you know where it's coming from. So it's like, you know what, I gotta appreciate that. So I have no complaints right about at this second. So just grateful to be here. Grateful to be here with y'all. You know, all of that jazz. How about y'all?
Shout out Mick Jenkins.
Straight up, man.
You heard that song?
What?
Jazz by Mick Jenkins. The water's mixed up. Oh my goodness.
Yo, you don't listen to Mick Jenkins, do you?
I didn't know we were gonna make this a thing, but
yo, Mick Jenkins,
I haven't heard his music.
Pretty decent.
It's some
pretty
good.
Above that.
Yes.
It's from him. Yeah, if that counts for anything.
Real poetry rap.
Yo. Real rap, if you will. Yo, speaking of real rap.
Real rap raw.
It's a real rap. It's a real rapper's birthday that happened yesterday.
Oh, man.
Yeah, you know.
You know. It's a real rapper's birthday that happened yesterday. The big 2-8, if you will.
Yeah, we didn't say that.
Blessings.
It's good to be here. Yo, this is getting nuts. Like, I'm 28. All right, let's everybody relax. All right, I've seen the posts and things, but 28 is what are we even talking about? Like,
he's still here, man.
The 20s. Now, when we get to the 30s, then you can holler at me.
We're gonna talk. It's gonna be weird being.
Well, we gonna rock the 20s out. You dig?
You gotta rock it out, man. How's it feel? Feel good?
Same. I think at a certain age, I don't know what age did it all start feeling the same. It's just like it doesn't matter anymore. What, like 25?
I'd say I'm about 3 years deep. I'd say 23.
Yeah, something like that. Nah, I was still rocking out at 23. Maybe 24. 24, 25, something like that. I was like, all right, enough. I don't. It doesn't matter anymore.
Said, all right.
It doesn't. It didn't really matter anymore. Like.
Speaking of your birthday,
you could, and I'm not saying like I'm just being morbid. Like you can tell, like, people, like, all right, nigga, you old now, like, I ain't finna.
Yeah, I mean, yeah, happy birthday, keep pushing.
Yeah.
Yo, what birthday was that when we had the hotel, the hotel bit?
What's that?
What birthday was that we had the hotel bit? Was that
19.
Yo. I'm not gonna go into detail, but that was the greatest one of your birthdays of all time.
That's what I'm saying. Like, when all that shit is done and over, then it's like,
yeah,
you get to certain whatever year that is.
Well, no, last year your birthday was pretty cool. The show, your album release party.
That was not last year.
2 years ago.
I didn't have one last year.
2 years ago, was it?
2010 cigarettes dropped. 2018.
Yes. Oh, yeah. 2 years ago. Yes. That was for Tea and Cigarettes. It sure was. The album out, bro. That's one of my favorite projects of yours, by the way.
Thank you, sir.
No, real talk. It really is one of my favorite projects of yours. Like, that one and Whatever, bro. Whatever probably is my favorite project of yours. Like, underrated. One of your most underrated projects that you've probably dropped. I live that. Right alongside with you, so.
So you heard it here. Go check that out.
Go check Whatever out. Absolutely.
I don't know what. Damn, I forgot what website it is. It's on its own website. It was on a Bandcamp.
Oh, shit. You still? Oh, yeah, Bandcamp.
Yeah, it wasn't dropped on.
Don't get music. Trash on Bandcamp. Is that still out there?
Yeah, that's realjrthegeek.bandcamp.com. But Whatever is something else.
That Piff. It's 100% that Piff.
It's right on that Piff, but it was on the Bandcamp too. Anyway, I digress.
Go get that.
Go check that out. That's what he was saying. That's what he was saying by all of that.
Yeah, it's great music. Good music. But this.
Nah, I appreciate that though.
Digression is hilarious.
So, and all in all, man, pretty. Did you get a? You know, how you feeling this weekend overall? Did you have a good week?
It was a good birthday, man.
We keep personal. Put that out there.
Yeah, not yet. So you knew where I was going with.
Oh, for sure.
Oh, yeah.
Well, I was gonna get there.
Okay.
Yeah, I just stepped on it.
I'm a little excited, so that's why.
All right. Now they made it a thing.
That's why this guy's my brother.
Right? I had a son this week.
Oh, my gosh.
2 days before my birthday.
Oh, yes.
That was a great birthday gift for that. That was a great one.
Are y'all going to share birthdays?
Yeah, no, that's what we were saying earlier. He came through and took it over. Because my birthday is on the 10th, my dad's is on the 9th, and he was born on the 8th. So he came through and shut everybody's birthday down.
How awesome is that, bro?
He said he came through and shut everybody's birthday down.
It's over for me and my
son. I have a nephew.
Yeah, man, so.
I have a niece and a nephew.
He came early. He came like a month early, so.
Baby elephant. Yeah. It's a calf.
But he's here, man.
The cat.
He was ready to come through, so he's here. He's being taken care of properly in the hospital because, you know, he did come early. But, yeah, blessings, man. It's all blessings all around. That's the best birthday gift I could get. And it came early, so, hey.
Right on time.
Yeah, man. Right on time, man.
Yo, I know this is a special flower segment.
That was great.
This is a special flower segment. Proud of this guy right here, man.
Yeah, man.
Proud of this guy right here, man. Real. Real guy right here. Proud of this guy right here.
Figure over here.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. y'all, this man, him and my other brother made me a crazy uncle 3 times over now. So,
can't
it's the rich auntie and the crazy uncle. So, I'm the crazy uncle. And he's just he's one of the few, just like me, the three club. Yeah. So...
That's another thing too. We all got the same name, and he just came all through. He shut all that out. He was like, "Nah, I'm
proud of this guy right here, man."
So yeah, this
was funny. Is like you literally handed it to him.
Yes, sir.
You came in and took all this,
no. No, he was supposed to be. He was supposed to come through in January. You know what I mean? And he was like, "Nah, I'm ready to come now, bro. I'm like, cool. It was good." So
I'm cool. I'll come.
What y'all doing out here? Yeah. Like, what y'all got going out here? What's that?
Yes. You guys may be a crazy uncle, man. And my mom is already going crazy and buying clothes and wipes. And I had to tell her it's not your.
Yeah, the fam is already.
Yeah, everybody's crazy. Already spoiling and going crazy. But this is great. So, that's great news right there, man.
Yeah, man.
Proud of this guy right here, man. Real example of what it means to be a father. you know, in this climate when fathers are far and few in between. This guy right here does everything. Daddy-daughter days, just, I call him and say, hey, man, what you doing? Man, just hanging out with my daughter, man. That's what we're doing today. So this is, man,
you got to. It's important.
That's what it's about, man. Real example, admiration right here, fellas. So that's some good stuff right there. Speaking of giving flowers, we have, dude, what you doing over there quiet for, man? Over there quiet, yeah, man.
Switch your camera angles.
Yeah, over there quiet, man.
Just giving the appropriate bouquet to the geek over there.
Well, go ahead and give one super to yourself, my brother.
Yeah, we're done with me now.
Go ahead and give one to you, my brother. What's been going on in the life of Judah, man? You know, I've been seeing a lot of great, great, great things.
Life of Judah.
That sounds like a that's reality like a show. Hey, or that.
A vlog or a reality show.
Like what y'all think.
Yo.
Man, I've
proud of you, man.
I appreciate that, dog.
No, on some real, like, on some brother things.
That's dope, dog. Networking has been, networking has kind of been the focal point of it all. Like, mm-hmm. It's been, I guess that is part of the business, but it's literally been meeting people and this connection leading to this connection, leading to these connections, mm-hmm. leading me out of state, leading me out of, like, it's weird. It's definitely not something I could call out. I can, you know, ask for what I ask for, mm-hmm. but as far as figuring out how I get there and mm-hmm. who I'm going to meet along the way, like, all that has surprised me day by day. So that's kind of what I'm going through right now, man. It's
just living it.
Yeah.
That's a dope part, bro. Working
process, bro. So I'll be, the 2021 year, I know I'll be traveling.
You'll be out of here. You'll be out of here.
Yeah, I'll real be in and out of the city, man.
Real travel boy things.
So, yeah, man. Shout out to Big Home for
Yeah, real travel boy things.
Gotta have plans, man.
Yeah, man.
Yes, sir. Dan.
2021 is definitely going to be a mobile year for AGP, for Judah.
Absolutely.
Overall, we'll be expanding, man.
Absolutely, bro. But, look forward to being a part of that.
I appreciate it. Yeah, new music on the way.
Absolutely.
Visuals on the way.
Finally.
Podcast on the way.
Finally.
Everything. Shit behind the scenes on the way.
Multimedia group right here.
Yeah, for sure.
Audio Productions.
This is the hub.
It's what we talked about for years.
Fuck with us.
Yes.
Fuck with us.
Yes. More merch on the way, by the way.
More merch on the way.
More shooters. More shooter merch on the way. But more you didn't hear that from me.
That's
Don't do it to him. Don't do it. Don't do it. Wait a
minute. Damn, man.
Hey. Don't do it to him. That's too much. Don't do it to him.
What we say? Everything's coming.
Everything's coming.
Pause.
No,
yes.
We already paused it.
It's coming.
I don't give a shit. I'm pausing it again.
It overlaps.
More episodes on the way.
It's not how pause works.
The rebrand is on the way. The elephants are on the way.
Yeah,
Judah the Shooter is on the way.
Sitting near you.
Oh, my God.
Sitting near you.
Oh, my God. More live shows on the way, but you didn't hear that from me. That's just, you got to hear that from me. Man. I mean, I saw the great Dave Chappelle do it. But, you know, that's just something off the top of my head. Y'all didn't hear that from me.
That was 20 minutes of pure greatness.
Yo. Oh, my God. By the way, have you guys seen that? By the way, can we just sidebar?
I mean, we could work together.
Or I could just take it.
Oh, the one on on Instagram? Hey, yeah, that was great.
That was a message, dog. I was saying talk now.
Jeez.
I was telling him talk doc like we was in church the entire
time. No, he definitely
special.
Had a sermon.
That was a message.
Yeah, that's every line was meant for, directed towards.
Mm-hmm.
It was catered to, like, it was for somebody. Every fucking line was meant for some.
No wasted words.
No way. No, bro. No, no, no.
That was it. That from the start to the finish, he was amazing.
And it's
something to keep watching.
That was
something
perfect.
Can I make a hot take? That might be one of the best specials I've ever seen in my life. And it's only 20 minutes.
I was about to say, and then it was only for it to be so short.
Only 18 minutes.
He was spitting.
It was perfect, bro. It was like the perfect special.
I will never watch this show again. Fuck, yo, until they pay him.
Yeah. Y'all better pay this nigga, man.
I learned something that people will take a lifetime to learn. Talking about the
yes, with the money. Yo, mess with somebody. How somebody eats.
He said I learned in a few seconds.
What niggas take 10 years to learn.
People a lifetime. You don't take food out of a man's mouth. Like, that is directed at somebody. You don't come and tell them what I'm... Don't... Like, if I'm in Africa, like, that's where it needs to stop. You make up this, hey, bro, he's doing this. This is why. Don't. What are you doing? Don't try to explain to them, fam. Like, I'm getting my money right now.
Screw your 50 yeah, mil.
You're fucking me over, bro. You be quiet.
Yes.
You be quiet. Let me handle my business.
Yes.
Fam, like, every line was direct. But shout out to the... That's why he is...
The greatest. Of my lifetime. I wasn't around when Richard Pryor and Red Fox was doing their thing. I saw Dave Chappelle.
Or other time. Yeah.
It
turned into, like...
You could say ours. Our.
Chat, bro. It started into story time. Like...
Word. That was saying, like, he just, like, you just shut up when he's talking like this. He just gave us a sermon real quick.
18 minutes. I can just take
crazy.
It. Either we can work together, you can get my money, or I can just take it.
Or.
Netflix was like, hey, yes, okay. We'll take it down. Easy.
We want to work with you. Please. We need more of these.
Give
specials.
Us another special.
Please. And we'll give you all the money.
We'll take that down immediately.
Now, Comedy Central.
They wrong for that. I don't care what you say, bro. Mm. What do y'all stand on that? Real quick, before we go to the next thing. Real quick, what do y'all stand on that when it comes to morals and business on that perspective? Like, do you think they should, now that he's a big star and now that they know he was a young guy, should they kind of amend that contract or should they just keep it? Because legally, they're not wrong. They're right.
It sounds like as soon as he... Because he went on the hiatus, he chose to walk away from the show, quote unquote. And it sounded like as soon as he resurfaced and put out anything else, it sounds like that's where he breached his contract. Like whenever he came back and did the interview, or came back and did the Saturday Night Live, or whatever he came back and did, it's like that's what I got out of the special. That's when he made a special he put out, was like, that's when he breached. So that's when they felt like, okay, he went out the lines. Now we're going to, he doesn't get anything.
Now we can put this on streaming service.
Now we're going to put this on every streaming. Like,
here we go.
I feel like maybe that's what happened, but I'm not for sure, but that'd be my take on it. Just he took one step out of bounds and
he came back.
And then, but. Every executive was like, oh no, you went outside the lines, now it's our time. Like, you breached contract, well, we're finna breach the fuck out this contract.
Yes, he went on Saturday Night Live on election night and said, I didn't get paid for my special. The biggest night of probably Saturday Night Live's, like, night was election night, probably of 2020, probably the biggest night of the year. Yeah. And Dave Chappelle did the monologue. And he went on national TV and said, I'm not getting paid for this. Stop watching this.
It's tough.
That means something, bro. Like, that's what they say all the time. Like, that means something. You are 100% right, Judah. Like, he probably went outside the line and did something they didn't like, or just simply came back after saying, I'm gone. Because once he was gone and went to Africa, like we were saying, they pulled it off TV. We didn't see it no more.
Nah, they came out with a whole season 3 while he was gone.
Like Charlie. Oh, Murphy, okay. Yeah, you're right. What's his name?
He only did like 3 episodes, and then they just put together some shit for the rest of the season. But yeah, he had nothing. It was like some old skits and shit, like some extra skits.
I think that was part of his part of what he. I've heard him say was. Like, yeah, well, shit, you're good, fam. We got shit in the vault.
It's like when somebody, like, yeah, so he left.
Real talk, man.
That's a tough one to be a part of, bro. But to see him as emotionally attached to it, kind of.
Bro, that's just life.
That's what made it really, really real.
That's just life. That's artistry. That's his artistry. You took his art and without paying him and putting on streaming services and reaping all the rewards and not giving him anything.
That's a tough one.
Which brings me to real artistry, Elephants in the Room. Elephants in the Room. More scars for the scummy.
Yes, sir.
Yo, Elephants in, I can't wait to see the rollout for Elephants in the Room. I just wanna watch it. You know, I don't have to be part of it. You don't have to be like, oh, Ronnie, you know. I just wanna see
what
it
was. What was that move? Do it again.
I just wanna see when it comes out. I just gotta see how in matching black trench coats flapping that motherfucker.
So you do wanna put it together? Because what you're doing is naming ideas.
That's producing.
That's what it's
doing. I just got to see that. We're hearing loving you is easier to do. That's enough. That's enough. I ain't gonna give y'all too much. I gotta hear that.
This nigga is crazy.
Yo, I gotta see that in black and white for the rollout. I gotta see that.
You heard that. That was another idea. So he's producing. So we're in trench coats and in black and white. All right. Okay.
Matching trench coats, by the way. It gotta look the same.
I don't know where Judah got is.
Yo,
I think all trench coats kind
of look the same. That's not true. Black and white.
That's not true.
Will it matter? Because it's gonna be black and white, and people won't be.
Yeah, niggas. If the lay is different, like yeah. If it got goddamn different.
But if y'all wear the same black turtleneck, it probably wouldn't matter.
Oh, we're also in turtlenecks now. Turtlenecks are under the trench coats.
Turtleneck boys.
Now we're finding out what we're wearing as a base. Now we're getting more information.
Y'all are sick.
No, you're sick.
I gotta see that and just hear that in the background and the cover. Yo, was that, can I ask y'all a person, was that the cover art for it?
That is it. With
yes.
Yep.
Okay.
That is it.
Mm-hmm. That was cool as hell, by the way. That is it. I gotta
the
see
the orange man.
Yes, I would love to see that. With
I was wondering how could I say this without saying it?
Yeah, that was perfect.
Orange man.
The orange man. That was perfect. I would love to see that on like the little Apple Music.
Senator.
Senator. Senator.
But no, yeah, that's definitely it, bro. That's definitely it.
Yo, will that be
artists, your... If y'all have not signed up for your... if it's not BMI, what is it? ASCAP?
ASCAP, BMI,
artist.
Either one.
Make sure you sign up for that.
Please. Sign up for it. Make sure you get your royalties, man.
Y'all got to get y'all royalties.
I can't remember which one is a free service, but one of them is free.
BMI.
It's not BMI?
ASCAP.
So ASCAP, please. ASCAP me Jones.
Can I just... Process of elimination.
Unless you're under management, get you a BMI or both.
I ain't gonna lie to you. They still gonna tell you to get ASCAP me Jones.
Yeah, but force them to.
Yeah, BMI, ASCAP. Sign up with Sound Exchange, TuneCore, whatever you get awesome. Your distributor. Hey, get your roses. Get your money, man. Get your money.
Talk. Nah, y'all right. That's some good advice right there.
I gotta be on it, nigga. I got kids.
Real talk. I got nieces and nephews.
OnlyFans coming soon.
Oh,
Patreon. Nigga,
y'all was right.
I'm gonna do goddamn everything.
Y'all might have been right.
We need what we doing? Sponsors. Come holler at us, man.
All of it.
We'll put your goddamn product right here, and we'll do ads.
End of the corner for sure.
We can do ads, man. We can read what you need us to do. And, man, I let us. I'm begging?
No.
That's what I sound like.
No, you sound great. I'm not saying anything.
I didn't have too much, Gene.
You sounded great. No, you're perfect. You're golden. That's why I didn't say anything.
Nah, 52.
All right, don't do that. Because now you're patronizing me.
No, I promise you.
Killed
it. Ha. Or I guide it. More scars.
That's what you always fucking say.
Was that? Oh, a shot. Pa-pow.
Ooh.
Not a pa-pow.
I got it.
Pa-da-pa-pow.
What'd you say?
Bibbidi-bobbidi.
Bibbidi-bobbidi. Okay.
More scars for the scummy? Coming out this month. That's what you was about to ask me before you changed the subject? Yes, sir, it is. Dropping this month, please.
Oh, is it this month?
Getting it done. We got to this month.
Whoa, that's exclusive.
It's the last month of the year. I said it's coming this year. It has to drop this year.
Are we out? Are we done?
Before January, please. I'm sorry.
Are we done?
We doing it. Yeah.
You done with it?
Yeah.
You thinking of a rollout? Most
definitely, 1,000%.
It's all about the rollouts, guys.
Hey, it's a quick rollout. You feel me?
It's for sure.
We're here. But yeah, it's weird.
Do you make a guest appearance on More Squad for this coming? Judah?
There are zero
features.
More scars for the scummy.
Good.
But, you know what? I'm not going to make that announcement yet. Let me chill. You got me too hyped. You trying to do something else. I'm with you. It's all about More Scars for the Scummy, the EP. Focus on that. And
Elephants in the Room.
I don't think that's coming this year, is it?
Is Elephants in the Room coming this year? That's y'all. I don't want to.
I'm going to tell you like this. This is the last month of this year. So
it's however y'all feeling about that. I would love to see like a full rollout, maybe first quarter next year. How would y'all feel about a first quarter rollout?
This is behind the scenes.
Behind the scenes conversations, you're right. People don't even know what first quarter means. Y'all don't want to play with me.
The people know what first quarter means now.
Well, yeah,
because of Twitter.
If they listened enough, yeah, first quarter.
Yeah. So yeah, More Scars for the Scummy is coming soon. If you haven't seen the cover art, you're a loser.
Mm-hmm.
I haven't dropped the track list because I ain't got time for all that shit. You finna see it? I'm dropping it this month. Yeah, we got more videos coming soon. We still got the light version of the Weekenders coming soon. Thank you, sir. Good,
yes, sir.
Good man. Light version of the Weekenders coming soon.
It's really blue.
Before the album.
Ooh. What? Like really blue.
Directed, produced, and filmed.
Blue, like,
by...
as in the tint or like the feeling?
Like color.
Oh, okay.
Directed, produced, and filmed by the great Audio Guided Productions, our brother Judah the Shooter.
Well, I think we would both be directors on that. Cause
yeah, co-director.
Oh, okay. Excuse
but
me.
Produced, and what else did you say?
I said produced, filmed, directed.
Okay, well, we got to stop that, because ain't film and directed like the same? No,
absolutely.
You're right, because I just added myself as a director. I didn't film it.
You didn't film
it. I don't know if I said his name right.
Film produced.
You did.
Because that's what they'll be saying on like Tyler Perry movies.
Scorsese. I'm not fucking Scorsese. Scorsese does the camera angles.
I'm not
fucking
Scorsese.
I'm not fucking Scorsese.
I don't understand. Is it crazy because of y'all are immature? Or is it crazy because...
I'm not Scorsese.
Just, there's certain words.
Scorsese is funny
certain
too.
Certain patterns of words you just never imagined
you
in your life.
Yes.
That's one of them.
So y'all are immature and y'all took fucking as something else.
No, not that. It's funny hearing you say, I'm not fucking Scorsese. Like, whoever think to call you like fuck. You're a young Scorsese.
No, people would call me that. More. First of all, don't disrespect me.
Your filming ability, your directing ability.
I can hear somebody.
The only reason I said that I should be co-director is because it was my idea.
Right.
But Judah was there to do the placements in the film, and he was also filming it.
And produced it.
And all the rest of the actors.
And directed it as well.
I
co-directed.
That's what I said.
That's all.
No.
No, we're not going to do that. We're not gonna do that.
That's what I said.
We're not gonna do
all
that.
All I did was have the idea and provide the idea and the placement.
Judah did everything else.
Placement, location.
Yes.
All right, we're doing too much. What is this?
This is good stuff right
give
here,
me,
fellas.
What else we got? We did More Scars for the Scummy coming soon, or excuse me, not
Live
soon, this month.
This month.
Live version of the Weekenders is coming before the album, EP. Elephants in the Room, first quarter. Don't talk to me.
Oh,
what else? What's good?
I think you covered everything, brother.
Covered it, brother.
You did it.
Covered
did
it like it. A blanket.
Absolutely. Yo,
boo!
Absolutely.
Out like a light.
Absolutely.
That was a trash ass bar that I just dropped on these.
That was pretty
young
atrocious.
Bucks.
Young bulls. But yo, this, yo. Drew,
you know, you dropped her. Because, you know, y'all niggas said I'm old, so I'm about
to...
All right, enough. End it.
No, you got two kids now. You got to start wearing Dockers and slacks and...
Oh, fail.
That's a good one.
The
ooh.
Dad sandals are...
Got to start wearing Dockers.
You got to
get a grill, too, right?
And a dad bod.
The leather weave.
Yeah.
When I'm grilling with the fucking Kiss the Chef, all that shit, right?
Like,
you niggas are hilarious. I hate both of you. I hit the mic. I'm out. I'm J.R. the Geek. That's Fat. Judah's making a mockery of me. This is Conversations with Elephants. I'm drinking too much gin. It's my birthday weekend. I don't give a shit.
Oh.
Yeah.
We yes, do sir. Have birthday weekends.
No. Okay, wait. Before we're out. No. Men don't have birthday weekends. Oops. It was my birthday yesterday.
Yo, fuck that. Celebration.
Girls Druda, have birthday weekends.
We love you.
Said I'd be hollering. Said I'd JR.